Hello, welcome back to the lecture series on mechanics of materials. This is under the initiative of VTU eShikshana program. In this module 4, we have covered so far the shaft subjected to torsion, the design of shafts, that is to find the diameter of the shaft subjected to torsion, and the cases which we considered so far was the shaft having uniform diameter or a single diameter subjected to torsion. But in most of the applications, to meet the requirements like to transmit the power at different speeds, we need to have shafts of different diameters so that you can mount pulleys of different diameters to transfer the speed, to transfer the power at different speeds. So in such cases, you need to have a shaft of different diameters, which is called as stepped shaft. So in this lecture, that is lecture 10, let us consider the torsion of shafts, that is stepped shafts subjected to torsion. Now, there are two arrangements you can see here. The stepped shafts may be connected in series or in parallel. So these are the two cases under stepped shaft subjected to torsion. So when we say that it is in series and when it is parallel, we'll see the arrangements. So you can see here, in the first case, the shaft in series means if the shaft is, you can see here the first arrangement, the shaft is having two diameters. One portion is AB, having a diameter of DAB, and the second part is BC, having a diameter BC, DBC. Okay, two diameters, two steps. And we can see that a torque is applied at the free end. One end is fixed here, that is end A is fixed and the other end is free. So we are going to say the arrangement as shaft in series when the driving torque is applied at one end, that is normally free end. You can see here the driving torque is applied at one end. Due to this torque, a resisting torque is developed at the fixed end, that is in the opposite direction. You can see here. Now the driving torque is in clockwise direction and the resisting torque is in anti-clockwise direction. You can see the different lengths here, length of AB and length of BC. Now such an arrangement is called as shaft in series. So the other characteristics of such systems are the resisting torque and the driving torques are equal, that is the driving torque applied is equal to torques in different steps. T1 is equal to T2 or TAB is equal to TBC, etc. So the torque remains equal in all the steps of the shaft. When you come to the angle of twist, you can see that the total angle of twist due to the torque applied is sum of the twist in portions 1 and 2, or suppose this is 1 and this is 2. This is 2. So the angle of twist in part 1 and angle of twist in part 2, the sum of this is equal to total angle of twist. And each shaft transmits the same torque. So that is this condition. So in case of shaft subjected to shaft arranged in a series subjected to torsion, we have maybe number of steps. Here we have shown 2, 1 and 2, or AB and BC. Normally, torque is applied at the free end, resisting torque developed at the fixed end. The torque transmitted by each step of the shaft remains same, whereas the total angle of twist is sum of the angle of twists in each step. Now, if I substitute for this equation, theta is equal to theta 1 plus theta 2, we know that according to torsion equation, T by J is equal to G theta by L. So if I substitute for theta, it is T into L by G into J. Substituting this in the above equation, I will get theta is equal to torque remaining the same, T into L1 by G1 at J1 plus T into L2 by G into J2. So that means, so the total angle of twist in the stepped shaft is equal to the sum of these two. Now suppose that if the shafts are, if the steps of the shafts are made up of same material, then G1 is also equal to G2. That means the modulus of rigidity for the two materials, two steps are same, G1 is equal to G2. So using these equations in this kind of arrangement, we can find the angle of twist provided the torque is given. So let us see the second arrangement, that is shafts in parallel. So when do we, that we say that shafts are in parallel? Now we can see that there is a, both the ends of the shafts are fixed here. You can see there are two steps here. Again, there is step one and this is step two, or you can say AB and BC. So this end is also fixed and the other end is also fixed. Okay. Now in such arrangements, now if the torque is applied at the interface, okay. Suppose driving torque is applied at the junction of two shafts, that is this between one and two. At the junction, if the torque is applied, a resisting torque is developed in at one end and another resisting torque is developed at the other end. Okay. So both in the opposite direction. Now this is in clockwise direction and the resisting torques are in anti-clockwise direction. So now in this case, the angle of twist remains same for both the shafts, both the steps of the shafts, as the, both the ends are fixed. So that is theta 1 is equal to theta 2, but the torque changes here. So if you take, you know, substitute here, if you substitute theta 1 is equal to theta 2 is equal to T1 L1 by G into J1, T2 L2 by G into J2. So the sum of the torque, the total torque applied at the junction T is equal to sum of the torques in individual steps of the shaft. So that is the difference between the shafts in series and shafts in parallel. So we can use these two equations to find the diameter of the shaft. So to find the diameter of the shaft in a stepped shaft or stepped bar subjected to torsion. Let us see some problems on this one. First, let us see this problem. A stepped shaft, as shown in figure, subjected to a torque of 100 Newton meter at free end C and a torque of 200 Newton meter in opposite direction at the junction. Calculate the total angle of twist at free end if the shear stress is 70 MPa and the modulus of rigidity is 84 GPa. So now you can see the diagram here. There are two portions, two steps, AB having a diameter of 100 mm. And there is a another part, that is BC having diameter of 50 mm. So now two torques are applied here, torque of 100 Newton meters at end C and 200 Newton meters in opposite direction at the junction. So B is the junction of ABC. So lengths are given here. So 1.2 meter and 1.8 meters. So now in this case, we need to find, calculate the total angle of twist. The question is total angle of twist. So in case of this arrangement, the maximum torque we can find, which is at BC, because BC is having the least diameter, the torque will be maximum here. So torque in BC is equal to pi by 16 tau into d cube as per our torsion equation. So if I substitute pi by 16, tau shear stress is 70. MPa, that is nothing but Newton per mm square. So diameter is 50, the diameter of the portion BC. So I'll get the maximum torque that is in BC as 171,8058.5 Newton millimeters. Now, this is the torque that is maximum in this arrangement. Now, let us find the angle of twist in BC and AV. So we have the equations from the torsion equation. Angle of twist in BC is torque into length by G into J. Substitute the torque here. Length is 1,800 millimeters. G is 84 GPa into 10 to the power of 3. And pi d fourth by 32. That is polar moment of inertia. So we'll get the angle of twist as 3.43 degrees. So that is the angle of twist in case of BC is 3.43 degrees. Angle of twist in AB, let us calculate with the same equation, torque into L by G into J. So taking the maximum torque again to design, length is 1200, 80 into 10 to the power of 3, pi d 4 by 32. So since in this case, that is series arrangement, TBC is equal to TAB. In case of series, torques are same in stepped shaft. We'll get the angle of twist in AB as 0.143. But he is asking the total angle of twist. So total angle of twist is theta PC minus theta AB because the torque supplied are in different directions. So angle of twist will be in different directions. So that is why we are taking a negative sign here. So the total angle of twist is 3.28 degrees. So that is how we are going to find the total angle of twist in case of such arrangement. Let us see one more problem here. Now, a circular shaft, stepped shaft shown in figure is fixed at end A and B. So when end A and B are fixed, now this is a parallel shaft arrangement of stepped shafts. Fixed at A and B, a torque of 100 Newton meter is applied at point B. Okay. That is at the junction, 100 Newton meters. Determine the resisting torque at supports. So the two torques are developed at the ends, which are called resisting torques and maximum shear stress in each portion. So now what is given here is torque 100 Newton meters, and then the modulus of rigidity 360 GPa. For each portion he has given, for AB and BC, since they are made up of two different materials. So lengths are 4 meters and 2 meters. Diameters are 80 and 40 mm. So now here, the total in case of parallel arrangement, total torque is sum of the torques in the two steps, that is TAB plus TBC. So let us find the torque equation. Torque is equal to, now we can write the equation, TB into LA divided by G into J plus TB into LS by GS into JS. So there are two different materials, aluminum and steel. So now we'll get the value here. And taking TB common here, torque applied to the junction. So if I take this common and solve for this, I will get, now this is the total 100 Newton meters, 100 into L by G into J. So that means torque in portion, both the portions are equal to the total torque. Now from this, we'll find the value of TB as 4.478 mm and TA, from this equation we can find TA is equal to 95.52 Newton meters. So that is the resisting torque developed at the each support. Next, we need to find the maximum shear stress in each portion. Now, maximum shear stress induced in each portion you can see here, for A, it is pi by 16 tau S into dA cube. So this is from torsion equation. From this equation, if I substitute, if I find for shear stress, I will get as 0.95 MPa. And for aluminum shaft, in the similar way, if I use the equation, TB is equal to pi by 16 tau A into dB cube. For aluminum, I will get the value of shear stress as 0.356 MPa. So these are the shear stresses induced in the parts, that those are stepped parts of the shaft. One is made up of steel and another is made up of aluminum. Now let us see another arrangement where a thin circular tube is subjected to torsion having capital diameter D and internal diameter small d. You can see the arrangement here. The length of the shaft is, length of the circular tube is L, having capital D outside diameter, then the small d inner diameter, and the thickness of the wall is given by D minus D by 2. Now in this case, the polar moment of inertia can be written as J is equal to pi dt outside diameter into thickness into d by 2 whole square. So pi d cube t by 4 is the polar moment of inertia equation for a thin circular tube. And if I write the torsional resistance, torque is equal to t by j is equal to tau by r. From that, t is equal to tau into j by r. And if I substitute for j in this equation from here, tau into pi d cube t by 4 r. So that is t is equal to pi by 2 tau into d square t. So this equation can be used to find the torque in a thin circular shaft subjected to thin circular tube subjected to torsion. Further, from the same, we can find the angle of twist of the tube over a length of L. So theta is equal to t into L, G into J, J into G by torsion equation. Again, if I substitute for J here, pi by 4 d cube t, I'll get the equation of angle of twist 4TL by pi d cube t into G. Now, if I want, I'm interested to find the ratio of torsional strength to weight. Torsional strength is T divided by weight W. So T by W is equal to T by W is rho into V, density into volume. In place of volume, I substitute pi d t into L. Pi d t is the area, L is the length. Then I can find the ratio of torsional strength to weight as tau into d by 2 into rho into L. So that is the equation to find the ratio of torsional strength to weight. Let us solve one problem on this one. A thin steel tube, 50 mm diameter, is having 2 mm thickness. If the shear stress is 80 Newton per mm square and modulus of rigidity is 80 GPa, determine the safe twisting moment and twist over a length of 400 mm. Now we have outside diameter 50, thickness 2 mm, shear stress 80 Newton per mm square, modulus of rigidity 80 GPa, length as 400 millimeters. Now, safe twisting moment we can find by the equation already we have derived. T is equal to pi by 2 tau into d cube d square t. So you can substitute tau is 80, and then diameter outside diameter is 50 into 2. We'll get this is the safe twisting moment. Similarly, twist over a length of 400 mm, 4TL, this equation, 4TL by pi d cube t into g. So if I substitute, I'll get the value of angle of twist as 0.92 degrees.